Now everybody and their mama thinking Skull Kid is gonna be in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I have no idea, but I personally think Skull Kid does have a decent chance of being in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. This is just what I think Skull Kid's moveset would be if he actually was in the game. So without further ado, I'm gonna get right into this and show y'all what I got. To start off, I'm gonna be going with all of his A moves. His jab, I think it should just be something basic, just a slap, slap, and then a kick upwards. Hops the opponent diagonally with a little bit of knockback, so there's potential for like a short hop up air, maybe a forward air to be able to connect. I'll get to what those are in later on, but you guys will see it coming. Up tilt, he should do his signature squatting move like he does in Majora's Mask, plus a little bit of a jump for a headbutt attack, similar to Olimar's up tilt is, but except it's one hit instead of like a multi-hit Toro move like he does. And with no DI, it'll pop the opponent straight upwards. You can use a forward air or up air afterwards at lower percent, depending on the DI of the opponent. Down tilt, Majora's Mask releases tentacles that performs a quick sweeping motion in front of Skull Kid. It kind of like sweeps back and forth twice, so it sticks it out, hits on the ground, and then just sweeps back and forth. Kind of like how you have the pinball machine thing, how it opens and closes, but no follow-ups will be possible from this. Now, one big key thing that I thought of when making this moveset for Skull Kid is that since it is a pair of Skull Kid and Majora's Mask, they both should be the ones to be able to fight, but they fight as one. Do you get what I'm saying? Anyway, you get what I'm saying. I digress. Forward tilt. Majora's Mask will sling Skull Kid's body in a quick horizontal motion that'll hit the opponent. Similar to when he took control of Skull Kid when he was fainted and he was slinging his body around. You guys remember that? I'm putting it up on screen anyway. Why am I even asking? Up smash. He squats just like a signature thing and then quickly stands up, sending out tattle and tail upwards. Each of them in a slight diagonal direction from his body, giving it a wider hitbox to the top. But since they don't come out until the end, there's less room to pick up opponents from the sides of Skull Kid's body. Down smash. It's just gonna be a simple split attack, the Skull Kid facing the camera. F smash. Tentacles released from Majora's Mask in a quick whip-like fashion, stronger at the tip of the tentacle. So these tentacles do have tippers, stronger, more like Korin's tipper is, rather than Marth, lashing out completely straight outwards, just like a whip would. Very quick, very quick. Dash attack. The mask takes control, lifting Skull Kid's body in the air, spinning him exactly horizontally, like his entire body. Akin to how Majora in his fight would turn himself face upwards and then spin his entire body on the ground when he would come toward Link, kind of like that. It would be a multi-hit similar to Mega Man's dash attack. For his neutral air, he would take the ocarina out of his pocket and release a small but strong sound wave, almost like a piercing sound wave all around his body, similar to how Greninja's neutral air is. He has combo potential and everything like that. I want to have Skull Kid to do almost the exact same thing, but instead of water, it's a sound wave when he's blowing on the Ocarina of Time, because he doesn't know how to play an ocarina. Forward air, a simple two-hit double kick move that launches the opponent outwards. Down air, throw his arms upwards, then back downwards under his body, releasing a telekinetic wave of energy. It will only be spikeable in the middle of the hitbox, but it won't be spikeable at the edge of the hitbox. Back air, a very powerful backhand move. This move will be imitated from what he did to Tail, I think, on top of the clock tower during the festival time at the beginning and the end of the game. He flips his body during this, so he begins facing forward. Exactly what he does in the game, and it also just happens to be what Marth does when he uses his back air. His up air will be, he will summon the three haunted boss masks from Majora's Mask and shoot them outward above his head. They'll be slightly wiggling wildly, mostly for animation, but it also allows them different reaches and different times and everything like that on different parts of the hitbox. Time for some specials. Ooh, the good part. Neutral be. Skull Kid will toss the mask forward. It will be a multi-hit move and it only will be a killing move if the last hit of the multi-hit connects at the max distance of the throw. You guys think I wasn't gonna put thought into this, but I am putting a little bit of thought into this, at least a little bit. If the character is hit before the max distance of the throw is reached, then the knockback will be weaker based on how much that distance actually is. Side B, flurry of up to 3 magic orbs release. Can be controlled similar to Pitch Arrow and Snake's Missile, but he can only launch up to 3, but he can choose how many he wants to shoot based on the number of B presses after side B is input. For 1, he'll just do side B. For 2, he'll do side B and then B again. And for 3, he'll do side B and then B 2 more times. I picked this move because I wanted it to take something from Majora's incarnation, the big bodied one. I wanted to take it from the move when he was throwing the flurry of magic orbs at Link during the fight, just tossing him the multicolored orbs and everything like that. I think that would have been great for his side B move. Up B, tattle and tail launch Skull Kid into the air, but rotation is applied, making an active hitbox around his entire body. It looks similar to Rosalina's up B, except for it has less range because there's not much fairies are going to be able to push a kid, right? I mean, they're not that strong. It will send still decent distance, but it will have an active rotating hitbox. Down B, he will drop a Deckernaut on the ground and explode after 3 seconds. Uncontrollable timing, like Link's bombs or Snake's grenades and everything like that, but is able to control the angle like Snake's grenades. Now for all of his grabs. Now his basic grab is just he'll be grabbing the opponent by the collar or the neck. His pummel will be a slower paced pummel rather than quick, so the tempo will be slap, pause, slap, pause, slap, pause, so something like that. Where he just be slapping the opponent in the face back and forth just because why not? That seems like the type of guy he is. Up throw, he'll throw the opponent upwards, spinning them clockwise. It's almost similar to how Broly's throw is in Dragon Ball FighterZ, how the opponent starts spinning really fast once he kicks them upwards, something like that. But he throws his arms completely upwards, kind of like how Vegeta does a little bit too. Back throw, I wanted to have just a simple spinning back throw that's just as powerful as like Mario's and Luigi's, something simple like that. He can have that. Down throw, throws the opponent to the ground, jumps high up, then sits right on top of them, exactly to like what he did when he stole opponent in Majora's Mask. Because what he did was to dodge Link, he jumped super high in the air and then he just sat on top of the opponent, and then she started running and everything like that. So I wanted to be taken from that motion in Majora's Mask, and it will launch the opponent backwards just because why not. Forward throw, throws the opponent forward, then shocks him with telekinesis. But another big part that I thought about from Majora that I want him to have, I wanted to be another float based character, kind of like how Peach is. So he will have a float where he has a signature leg crossing pose like he does all the time in the game, because he floats in the game because he has telekinetic power. So why not be a float character just so he can do that? He'll be able to use all of his moves outside of the float just like Peach does, or just as many moves as Peach can outside of her float. But except whenever he hits a move, not necessarily whiffs, but when he hits a move, he'll do like a big cackle like he does from his game. And I think that'll definitely add a little bit more spice to Skull Kid's gameplay. Now, of course, this is Smash, so when you're making a moveset for someone, you want to have the taunts in there too. So yeah, I went for the taunts too. His down taunt will be his signature stance where he's turning his head and his arms up back and forth in opposite directions at the same time, you know, everything like that. I'll put it up on screen if you guys no idea what I'm talking about. His up taunt would just be his simple signature evil laugh, you know, have the echoing in the background with the mirrored audio track and everything like that. Simple as that, and he'll be holding his stomach and everything like that. His side taunt will be him doing his little hopping dance thing where he moves his arms like above and below his body and everything like that, alternating between legs. If you guys don't know what I'm talking about, I'll put it up on screen again. This man is weird. But anyway, I still love to have him in the game. So that's gonna be pretty much it. That's what I think Skull Kid would have for his moveset if he were to be in Super Smash Bros. Ultimate. I do have high hopes for him being in the game, but if it's not, I won't be that disappointed. But if you guys did enjoy this video and want to see other moves like this for other characters that I would want to be in the game, then let me know in the comments below. Hit that like button if you enjoyed, and subscribe because I got more coming for you guys. I want to thank you all for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. But let me know, do you want Skull Kid in the game? Do you think he'll be good? Do you think he'll be bad? Or do you just not want him, period? Or do you just not think he will be in the game? All discussion, put it in the comments below. I'll read them all, respond to when I can. All right, see you all next time.